Hi, I'm Michela Massimi, and I'm a senior lecturer in philosophy of science in the School of Philosophy, Psychology and Language Sciences at the University of Edinburgh. Today I find myself at the National Museums of Scotland to introduce you to one of the most lively debates in contemporary philosophy of science, the debate between scientific realism and anti-realism. This debate is unlike many others that populate philosophy of science. It is not a debate about a specific topic or theme or theory in physics, biology or cognitive science, but it is a much broader debate about what science is all about and what we should expect from good science. In other words, this is a debate about the aims of science. We may all have intuitions about what the aims of science are, and there seems to be two possible views. On one view, science aims to be accurate, to provide us with a good description and analysis of the available experimental evidence in whatever field of inquiry that is. In other words, we may expect science to save the phenomena. On a different view, we may expect science not to just save the phenomena, but to provide us with a true story about those phenomena, how they came about, what sort of causal mechanism were involved in their production. And often telling a true story involves appeal to unobservable entities, entities that prove elusive to the human eye, like neutrinos, protons, DNA strands, and so forth. So, what do you think? Does science aim at saving the phenomena, or does science aim at giving a true story about those phenomena? Well, depending on how you answer that question, you will be siding either with scientific anti-realism or scientific realism. In the rest of this lecture, I will introduce you to these two main views very briefly and to some of the main arguments and counter-arguments. Asking what the aims of science are may sound ozio's armchair philosophy, but it's not. This is a central question that has shaped the course of Western science and has fueled some of the most important debate in our cultural history. Our story begins several centuries before Galileo and Newton.